Ooh, a piece of candy. 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 Ooh, a piece of candy.
Ladies, gentlemen, and monsters of all ages, are you tired of walking around with that crusty old thing around your neck? No, not the scarf that you let your pet Kezu chew on. I'm talking about the random talisman that you got 20 hours ago and promptly ignored afterwards. It's time for a change. A change for the better. A change to better talismans. And if you want them, as usual with any sort of grind or farming in Monster Hunter Stories 2, you best bet you gotta get your butt to that bram pot first to start off, and activate the gathering buffs to raise your chance of finding rare items in the field, because yes, this is a farming experience. Well, at least it is, unless you're a bottle cap billionaire. I mean, if you have no discretion for how much that you spend in the slightest, Melinx Inc. does have an option to repeatedly buy a mystery rare talisman for 30 bottle caps. Unfortunately, this doesn't guarantee you a ridiculously good one by any means, just a relatively rare one, a good rarity, high rarity one, essentially one guaranteed drop of a talisman that you could just normally find in a gold mining node. And that is what you'll be after today for the free option. Once you enter the post game and things start to become high rank, these golden nodes will have a chance to roll you a very strong talisman every time you pick one up in the wild. You can just find these passively while wandering through the open world, and they can even have a decent chance of spawning in high rank dens, and each time you see it could be a talisman. But this isn't just about saying get the golden rocks. Now, we have a couple of specific paths for you to mess around with for yourself, more for variety's sake than anything to keep you from getting bored. The first one then, which is a little bit less efficient but also quite fast for the amount of mining nodes that you pass, get yourself a flying monstie and head to Hartzagai Rocky Hills Inner Caravan Stand. From here, there is a mining node to your northeast that has a chance to be gold. Two mining nodes south of that can be gold. And then the first time you come through this, you do need to break the rocks to access this corridor to the west with one more mining node that can be gold. A quick fly up passage to access two more mining nodes, which can be gold. Refresh the area, check all the nodes. Each of them can be golden, and each golden node can be a rare talisman. If all you care about is talismans, only bother picking up the golden mining nodes. Skip the rest. Reset once you have checked each node, lather, rinse, and repeat. How you'd lather a talisman, I'm not quite sure. It isn't really a liquid, but I'm sure if you rubbed it hard enough, something would happen, like a strange necklace genie might pop out. Point is, you can do this loop in about 30 seconds pretty consistently. It's nice, combatless, brainless farming. However, this is not the only way to do this, no. I present to you what I can only imagine is the most purposely created by the developers grind spot that I've seen in a video game in ages, at least in my opinion. Love in a mine cave. And no, I'm not reading a strange romance novel marketed to pickaxe owners. I'm talking about this icy cave that just happens to be called the Mine Cave. And of course, very thematically, it's chock full of mining nodes. Not just plentiful in general throughout the cave as a whole, but quite specifically, there is also six that consistently spawn nearly within reach of the entrance of the cave. Each of them can be gold, and each golden one can give you a talisman. There is also a chance of an extra mining node spawning just around this tiny little corner right beside them sometimes, so watch out for that little bonus each time you walk through. Pick up all of these nodes and reap the rewards. Run out of the cave, run back in, and repeat. Six nodes, fast as all hell. It's worth mentioning that there are two mining nodes that spawn right outside of the cave too, but they don't respawn unless you loaded a caravan stand, so they aren't really part of your farming route here. Just a tiny bonus on the way if you want them. There's also another bunch of mining nodes that you can actually see from the entrance of the cave that are further away. Technically, it's less efficient to chase these down than it is to just go back out and into the cave, but sometimes I see a shiny thing and you gotta run at it. I know that feeling. I understand. Of course, on top of this, you gain a lot of resources if you're just here picking up all of the normal mining nodes along the way as well. Because, well, it doesn't really slow you down, especially on this route, as they are just so bunched up together. While charms may take a couple minutes of rotations in between to find, you definitely will find loads of trade-in items and local commodities as you go. Trade-in items, of course, being things that you can sell in town for loads of extra zenny to fuel your equipment buying, and the local commodities that you can use to complete repeatable high rank quests, which can level up your monsties quite well considering the very low risk involved for this process. So really, the whole thing has multiple rewards that it gives you. It's a pretty good use of your time if you're just looking for some nice, relaxing farming. What talisman are you looking for in this game? For me, I think weak point extra large is the key to what I want to achieve. I want to get weak point XL with an awesome secondary skill. Currently, my best combo that I have is the extra kinship generation at 50% health or lower, but I hate being that low health in general, so I'm probably going to keep searching. Alright everyone, I've been Cotton Dinosaur, and that's everything that you really need to know to get yourself a brand new pain in the neck. A good pain. The pain of skills. What's your coolest talisman so far? Tell me so I can be jealous. Like if you like the video, subscribe to the notification bell for more, and most importantly, ladies and gentlemen, until next time, stay sweet.
Josh, Cotton, and Hollow with the videos, dropping the humor like a hammer on your tippy toes, bringing entertainment on a daily arrangement to take our insanity and turn it into entertainment. Yes, I said entertainment twice, to reiterate that it is nice to look into your faces on a mostly daily basis when you let us in your homes to make the whole world a stage. Goodbye.